We can all agree that an education is one of the most important things a child needs. There are several ways to do this, and the Fusion Academy in Columbia has made it a point to give each student a one-on-one classroom experience that helps academically, socially, and emotionally. With their integrative health approach to education, the benefits on students' health and wellness is pretty amazing. Nicole Weston is the head of school and joins me this morning to talk about how the Academy achieves this. Good morning, Nicole, and welcome to Maryland Perspective.
Yeah, hi, good morning, Amelia.
Now, before we get into the details, tell us how the Fusion Academy got started.
That's one of my favorite stories to tell. Michelle Rose Gilman is our founder, and she was a special ed teacher. And in 1989, she ended up starting a tutoring and learning center, really as a result of her experience. She was working as a director of education in a day treatment program first, and then they lost their funding 6 months in, and once they lost their funding, she then took all the students who were there, needing now a place to learn, and helped to support that process until they found appropriate placements for them, and then she opened up her tutoring and learning center in 1989. Then about a decade later, she discovered that they were really having an amazing impact on the students' lives. But yet, a lot of the students were still in the more traditional model schools, their local location in Solana Beach, California. And the students were just not thriving. So they'd come in to the tutoring center, and she would see them making improvements, and then they'd return to their more traditional school and really struggle. So she was a young 20-year-old at the time and said, you know, I think we just need to turn this into a school. So she did.
Good for her. That's amazing. A lot of people don't have those kind of guts. You know, it takes a lot to say, I'm going to start a school and then go ahead and back it up with all of the work that it takes to do that.
Yeah.
So what are the ages that the Fusion Academy works with, and who are you finding that you help the most compared to traditional schools?
We're a 6th through 12th grade school. So our students are coming in roughly at the age of 11 till 18, but we can take students who are a little bit maybe behind and need a little bit more time to finish their degree. What we're finding in this area in particular is we're seeing a lot of students who aren't thriving in the traditional model, whether it's because they have a medical condition that kind of gets in their way and they sometimes need to pace a little bit longer in order to complete their work without it piling up on them because of being out for medical reasons. But we also are seeing that we have a lot of students who are experiencing just a lot of anxiety, a lot of pressure around performance, pressure to achieve really high results, and they're really struggling with that pressure. And so we see students who are in places of school refusal. And once we get them in the door and we start working at their pace, we see a huge difference in turnaround for a lot of those students.
It sounds like that's how you're integrating the mental and physical health into the process of learning. So you're sitting down with the student, you're finding out why they're so anxious, and then you're just sort of getting rid of all of that and focusing on what's going to help them learn the most.
Yeah, that's absolutely right. The admissions process for us is we spend a lot of time learning each student's story. What are they experiencing? If they're experiencing anxiety, is it around being in front of others? Is it school anxiety? Is it connected to performance in class? Once we kind of understand those pieces, then the teachers are kind of armed with that information and can make adjustments as needed. We can even adjust when students are taking courses. So if it's a particular class, if we discover that a student is experiencing such a severe degree of school refusal that they're not able to even make it into school, and it maybe starts and is centered around, let's just say, English for an example, when they come to us, we can say, look, let's hold off on English. If that's getting in the way, let's take it off the table for right now, and we'll return to that later when we're ready. And so we can move that to the end of the school year and just work on reengaging them in learning and finding it fun and curious and to rediscover that instead of having it be all about performance.
So it sounds like, well, I was going to ask you about a typical day that a student would go through, but it doesn't sound like you have any typical days.
Yes, that is correct. Everything is customized for us. We customize the time of day that the students have classes. So if we have students who really the morning does not work for them, we can move their classes until after lunchtime and they can come into the evening. What is the same for most of our students, they'll attend class and then they'll go to a homework cafe to get their work done. and then they'll go to their next class and then go back to Homework Cafe to get their next to get their work done. So they're actually getting their homework done on campus with us.
Nice.
With some supervision and support. We find that the students help one another during that process, and then they don't have to take it home. So when they go home, they're free of it.
And I would love to have had that when I was in high school. That would have been great, because that's really what it's about. It's about learning and doing whatever you need. That way you're freed up for after school activities as well, whether it's sports or maybe you want to pursue music or art, or, you know, I know that's what you do at your school as well. You definitely delve into the arts and also into music, but to be able to go home and have time to practice on your own without that pressure, it sounds amazing.
We actually have a whole program built around the art and music expression too.
So, not to put too fine of a point on it, Nicole, how much is tuition and can families get help paying for it?
Obviously, we get that question a lot. The best way to understand our tuition is to understand how we work with families. So, we are a full-time school, but we also offer individual classes for credit that can be transferred back to homeschools. And so, we have some students that are enrolled full-time. We have some students who are enrolled part-time that blend a little bit of fusion with a little bit of homeschooling or a little bit of fusion with a little bit of online school. Or we have students who are in more traditional models and they just take a single class with us. It makes the most sense for us to break it down by class since we work with families in all of these different ways. With that said, the way that our tuition is set up is we can look at it by a single semester for like an elective class, like maybe a recording arts class that is not a full year but just a single class. So a single class for one semester is roughly $4,200. If we're looking at a full year, so like for English full year, or even that recording arts, we want a full year, so like two semesters, that's $8,400. And our typical students take six classes if they're full-time students.
Okay. And then you also offer tutoring. So if a student needs help with a certain subject, like you were saying, they could either sign up for the whole class or they could just get tutored upon that, right?
Yes. We do a lot of SAT prep or even prepping students to take tests for their other independent schools. They can get math prep. But we can also use those classes for enrichment as well. So if somebody wanted to, again, let's say, get into our recording art studio, but they didn't really want it to be tied to credit, they just wanted to tinker and play a little bit, they can come in and do that as well.
Fantastic. So where do people go to get more information on the Academy?
The best place to go is our website. And you can just FusionAcademyColumbia.com.
Nicole Weston is the head of school at the Fusion Academy in Columbia, Maryland. And I'll make sure I get those links up on our website. Thank you so much for telling us about another way that students can unlock their potential.
No, thank you. I appreciate your time, Amelia.